Last time on our exclusive coverage of the $500,000 Ultimate Bowls Championship, The Point, hailing from Tarrant Point in Sydney's Sutherland Shire, won the second semi-final in comprehensive fashion.
Axon's now very interested. Axon just hoping for it to be nice and steady here. Will it get past the bowl? It gets past and down for a touch-up.
So The Point from Tarrant Point in Sydney, Mighty Bowls Club it is too, through to the final. So the scene is set for an epic finale as The Point clashes with Melbourne's Dandenong Club in what shapes as a game for the ages. There's a $60,000 winner's check and the pride and prestige of winning the second round of the world's biggest bowls tournament. Also on today's show, we catch up with emerging tweed head star Chloe Stewart. Our coverage proudly supported by Ryman Healthcare, Aero Bowls, Sports Centre and the Deer Park Club.
We're all set for the final here at the Ultimate Bowls Championship, round two at Deer Park Club. Now, Georgia, you're about to head ringside and talk to these guys. What is the nerves and excitement going to be like on the rink?
I think there's going to be some tense players. There's definitely going to be some nervous players as they head out to the rink for the final. But overall, it's so exciting to be heading into the final stages of event two here at Deer Park.
And being that you're the last person to chat with these guys, any final words of advice?
Yeah, I think they've definitely just got to go out and have some fun. You know, this is a really big deal and making the final is huge. There's lots of money at stake, but the main thing is to get out there and have a ball on the rink.
What do you think is more important to that, guys? That $150,000 prize money or taking out the glory of being the round two winners?
Wow, it's hard. There's a lot of money at stake, but I think it's definitely the glory.
Can't wait to crown the round two victors here at the Ultimate Bowls Championship.
Thank you, Ebony and Georgia. Great to have your company, folks, wherever you're watching. And welcome to this much-anticipated finale between Dandenong Club, arguably the form team of this competition, and The Point. I'm joined in commentary by Chris Green.
Tappy, I can't wait. But firstly, let's catch up with one of the emerging Australian players, Chloe Stewart.
Chloe, appreciate your time. You started playing the game of bowls as a nine-year-old. Who inspired you to get involved at that age?
So back when I was nine, I used to go and watch my grandma play on the school holidays. And yeah, she just sort of encouraged me to have a go. So yeah, I got out there and just started playing with her and the guys at Kite and Bowling Club. And that was it. Fell in love.
You're in your early 20s now, so you're well credentialed to comment on this. There is a perception in the public arena that bowls is for the elderly. Not so. A lot of young people playing the game. You're one of those at an elite level. But with the advent of things like barefoot bowls and what have you, it has opened the sport up to a whole new audience.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, barefoot bowls is massive now. You know, on the Gold Coast, you know, with the great weather that we have all the time, it's so good to see so many people, you know, in their early 20s, 30s, whatever age, coming out and starting to have a go. And it's just really good to see.
You're forming a part of the powerful Tweed Heads team in the Ultimate Bowls Championship. Can I ask your impressions of the opening event at Warilla back in April? Did it exceed your expectations in terms of the format and the way it worked out?
Yeah, absolutely. I loved it. I was raving about it when I came home to Tweed Heads. And I think it's really, really good for the game to have, you know, sort of 2020 of bowls. And, you know, if anything, I think it's really going to help the sport.
Mark Casey and his colleagues at the helm of the championship are very much driven by the ethos of trying to get new people involved in bowls. In your opinion, will the UBC help achieve that?
Absolutely. I really think so. You know, the fact that it's on TV, you know, mainstream TV, you know, it only takes a couple of people to just sort of click over and see it. And because it is so fast-paced and, you know, you've got the different colours and, you know, the uniforms and, you know, everyone out there is, like, pretty young. So I think it's definitely going to help.
You're watching the Ultimate Bowls Championship from Deer Park in Melbourne. Our coverage proudly supported by Ryman Healthcare, Aero Bowls, Sports Centre and the Deer Park Club. Thanks for being with us, everyone. Welcome back to the Deer Park Club in Melbourne, the finale of round two of the Ultimate Bowls Championship. Dandenong Club and the Point. David Tapp and Chris Green with you in the commentary box. Georgia White downstairs. A capacity crowd. And before we unleash the action in this game, one of our principal corporate partners, Ryman Healthcare, have introduced the Ryman Activation at this event, which involved Chris Green selecting people out of the crowd. And that process now brings us to the final here. And the name of the game is to simply land the bowl as close as possible to the jack.
Yes, Tappy, a little bit of fun here before the final action. So we've got red, blue and black. I'm going to go for the young fella at the back. He looks like he's no nerves there. He's ready to go. And the pace has been set, but it's not real good.
Great opportunity for people here as spectators to sample the championship rink that in a couple of minutes will host four of the world's best players doing battle for a $60,000 winner's check. Now, the young bloke out there, boy now on screen, is Kobe Cromie. And a left-hander, as you can see, and the crowd giving him plenty of support. And I've got to say, it looks pretty good.
Yes, he's just getting in early. He could be a draft pick next year for the UBC. Look at this, Tappy.
That is brilliant from young Kobe.
He can't believe it. That's sensational. And the winner of that Ryman activation, picking up a set of Aero bowls, valued at nearly $700. So that's a terrific prize. So well done to young Kobe. And a big thank you to Ryman Healthcare for its ongoing support of this, the inaugural Ultimate Bowls Championship. There is the happy bowler on screen. And right now, the Dandenong Club representatives in this finale, Gary Kelly and Barrie Lester, they've swept all before them in this championship, ably supported by the great Wayne Turley. And of course, the Point players on screen as well. They won't be fazed today in any way, shape or form. I refer to David Axon and Ali Forsyth and Chris Green, wonderful players on the rink.
Absolutely. As we see here, Barrie Lester, Gary Kelly. They won event one, event two. They've been outstanding once again. One of their trademarks is big points early on. They've scored 20s, 22s, 24s, just leading up in that first end. It really puts everyone on the back foot. So that is the challenge here for the Point. Right here, right now, N1. They're going to stop Dandenong scoring those big points, getting away early.
And man on screen, Lester, has made an art form out of beginning well. We've seen him in sublime touch all television games in this championship thus far. And once again, he delivers an excellent bowl to start proceedings. Now Axon's turn to respond.
Yeah, the matchup between these two leads is very interesting here, Tappy. You got Baz, he's proven performer at lead. Axon, traditionally a skipper, he brings a bit of that into his lead game because he's very attacking. I'd be very surprised if we don't see a couple of big attacking shots in the lead role from Axon today.
Dandenong's road to this final. Victory over Cabramatta in the quarterfinal. Then too good for ITP Queensland in the semis. As we see Lester in action again here. And of course the Point defeating the Navigators in the quarters. And then Deer Park in the semis to find themselves here in the big dance.
Yes, almost a fairy tale there for the host Deer Park. And what great hosts they've been. What a great event too it's been. And this final, what it shapes up to deliver here for the crowd. It's nothing short of amazing.
No score at this stage. Almost got our first 3 points for a toucher there. There was only a whisker in it. Yes. Massive crowd in. The place is packed and it's freezing cold. But the action on the rink, I'm sure, Chris, will boil over.
100%. Speaking of points, for the people who are tuning in, maybe for the first time or want a refresher, 3 points for a toucher. And that's every toucher. You get 3 points. If you're holding shot at the lead crossover, it is a further 3 points for your team. Then at the conclusion of an end, first shot is worth 10 points, second shot, 5 points, third shot, 3 points. You get first, second, and third, 18 points, and it is the ultimate end.
And we saw the Point claim an ultimate end in their semi-final victory over Deer Park, and in fact propelled them to the lead in that game. And so there it is, lead shot going to the point. We walk back down the rink with Ali Forsyth and Gary Kelly. Great camera, that Steadicam unit. And a recap of the action in that first end.
Big Axon on screen. Four world champion stars here, Tappy. We've got David Axon, the Welsh Wizard. Barrie Lester, we know what he does for Australia. Ali Forsyth, New Zealand. Gary Kelly, Northern Irish superstar. Kelly, the big bowls that he plays, the crowd love. So does that man at the bottom of the screen, Barrie Lester. The boys, enthusiasm from both sides will be big in this final. See Gary Kelly delivering nice and early. Still the point holding shot. As mentioned, very important for the point boys to be scoring early, but also minimising Dandenong. Dandenong, the trait of getting out nice and early, big points on the first end.
As we watch the action here, with end one continuing and the point leading 3-0, I'd just like to very quickly announce the dates of the Ultimate Bowls Championship for 2020. You can see them now on screen. It'll get underway, in fact, at this club, Deer Park, on April 2 and 3 next year. The Warilla Bowls and Recreation Club will host round 2, August 13 and 14. And then the Moama Club in Victoria host the third and final round on December 10 and 11. And of course, a reminder, Moama also hosting the final round of this year's championship, December 12 and 13.
Yeah, a little change there, Tappy. Deer Park and Warilla swapping around between events 1 and 2, as opposed to this year where Warilla hosted the first event and here we are, second event at Deer Park. Probably adds to a little bit of comfort too.
You can say that again. Definitely.
A bit unfortunate there for Forsyth. May have just rolled his bowl out of shot. Will be very close. Interesting while you're going through the dates there, Tappy. Gary Kelly just went through a hole. We don't often see that. We normally see contact from Kelly. It's one of the things with bowls, with this short, sharp format, if you don't get luck early, it can play on the back of your mind.
Oh, without a doubt. So Barrie making it seem easy. He's saying you'll get a toucher.
Just that confidence these players have got in each other. And that's a big thing too. With pairs, you've got one other person on the rink with you. They've got to be calling confidently.
Watch Lester. He'll urge us on. Not unusual to hear. Baz screaming the joint down. And not quite what they were looking for. Would you call Gary Kelly's delivery orthodox?
I'd say orthodox for overseas, Tabby. Now that's one thing you'll see, especially the European players. They've got very interesting deliveries, but what they do is they do the same thing over and over. Big opportunity here for Forsyth and the point. You can get down to the jack, trail it, even if he sits the shot bowl. The good news for them is they've got plenty of bowls in their head, so they will be scoring this first end, and Dandenong, they might only be getting one scoring opportunity here. Boys in the crowd going off. Axon will let us know.
Will he ever on its way? And there's a toucher for the point. So 14 now plays 10. You can just see the tension on the players' faces, can't you? And you can feel the tension in the venue. Look at the look on Ali's face. Replay of that toucher. And the point doing a splendid job at this stage. You look at some replay action here in the UBC.
If you haven't already, be sure to get on the Ultimate Bowls Championship Facebook page and give the guys a like. More stats, videos, player profiles can be found on here, and it's an amazing community to be a part of. We'd love to see you there.
Welcome back. A lovely aerial shot of Australia's sporting capital, Melbourne. And just down the road, we're broadcasting from the Deer Park Club. If you're just joining our coverage, it's the Ultimate Bowls Championship, the world's biggest tournament. And this is the finale in round 2. Dandenong Club, who also swept all before them in winning the opening round at Warilla back in April. They play the point, and right now the point They're in front by four.
Absolutely. And the first thing they have done, which is highly important for their chances in this final, is keeping the first end nice and tight. And not only that, they're leading by four, as you said, 14-10. Ali Forsyth, just unfortunate with his last bowl not to get all the jack, but Barrie Lester, and this is just what he does. He's got a smile in the background. He loves playing big events, especially the lights, the cameras, touch it nice and early, score back to 13-14.
So now Axon sends another one down. Chris, it would be remiss of us if we didn't pay tribute to the third player associated with these clubs. Both of them have done an exemplary job for Dandenong Club, Wayne Turley, and of course John Green for the point. They've certainly done their bit in ensuring their respective clubs
best
have
mates
arrived
off
for
the
this
green.
Big one. Yeah.
Best mates off the green too, which is interesting. I wonder if they're standing next to each other.
I have a feeling they're not. So 14-13, a thriller. Second end of competition. Second end of five. A little long.
But next to the dot. That blue dot for the re-spot. So that's the opportunity. He's always reaching through the head. If you're not going to touch her or getting the shot, giving yourself an opportunity. Axon, once again, just underneath the line there. Barrie Lester, he'll be looking to add another shot. Doesn't want to fatten the target up, though, because we know how aggressive David Axon can be. Lester just taking his time here. Normally very fluent on the mat, knows what he's going to do, and just plays that left-hand smooth delivery, smooth as silk. That's textbooked right there.
I think I read somewhere that Lester is in line, or maybe will be nominated as the International Bowler of the Year. In male competition, fair rap, and an accurate reflection of the 12 months he's had.
Been a big 12 months, big 12 months. As it has for all bowls in Australia. Now, the Australian sides have been just brilliant on the world stage. Well, here we go, Axon, only end two, he's running. He's running the jack here, needs contact. He's got contact off the blue bowl, follows it into the ditch. 3 points, a further three for the lead shot. And look how close he sat there. This will be some task for that man, Gary Kelly, as he's walking to the mat. There wasn't any smiles then.
Indeed, a recap. The Lester bowl, which was outstanding. Great focus on the player's face. And that was followed up by this.
There's that little bit of skipper coming out of him there. Look at that focus. He's just following it down. Even the boys in the background, the crowd there, they're all watching. They don't want to miss a bowl here. This final for UBC event number two. Dandenong, the point.
O'Kelly, one of the world's great players, annexing the World Cup indoors back in March.
It's pretty close here, Tappy. Baz is liking it. Is he going to sit up? This could be the shot. What a bowl. There we go.
Okay. Yeah, look at Barry shaking his head. You're kidding. Like, wow.
Oh, yeah, Gary Kelly loved that. The boys in the background there, you've got some of the best players in the world, and they're cheering it on. Ali Forsyth, no surprise here. He is attacking the bowl and just misses underneath. Made contact with the toucher in the ditch. That'll just go back to where its original position was. Gary Kelly. Interesting here. He doesn't want to get too close to make the target any wider. He doesn't want to fall in the ditch. Just a good, solid third shot would be his aim here, because as we know, third shot will still get points.
Because Gary won the bronze medal in men's singles at the 2010 Commonwealth Games. It's really when he burst to prominence on the world stage. And the focus of Forsyth is immense.
Okay, so Ali coming off a runner here, back to the draw. Looks quite short here. That's not like Ali at all.
Uncharacteristic.
Yeah, he blocks up the runner too now, Tappy. Look, sometimes, even though they've all been playing this format, and it is a different format, sometimes you can almost forget the fact that 3 points for third shot. You know, you can almost be going for shot, like if you're playing a normal traditional match. So that sometimes can come into effect. The bowl right out near the sideline here. Will he get back in bounds? He's already got third shot, but a closer third shot is what he's looking for. OK, Okay, first shot here to Dandenong. Second to the point, courtesy of the toucher in the ditch from David Axon. And third shot to Dandenong.
The thing here is, if a player is not happy with the shot, they're experienced enough and good enough just to forget it and move on.
100%.
That's life.
100%. And this surface is fantastic as well here. Just looking at me hold up here for third. Might need to slow down a touch.
And he starts to.
He's going to hold up here, and he does. Okay, another big end there for the point. First and third shots. Second shot to Dandenong. This final is living up to all expectations. The point leading 28-23.
Thanks, Greeny. As the guys get set to start the next end, we'll take a quick break. Plenty more Ultimate Bowls Championship after this.
You're watching the Ultimate Bowls Championship from Deer Park in Melbourne. Our coverage proudly supported by Ryman Healthcare, Aero Bowls, Sports Centre and the Deer Park Club.
Where else would you rather be than at the Deer Park Club in Melbourne? The finale of the Ultimate Bowls Championship, a $60,000 winner's check up for grabs here. In a tournament paying $500,000 overall, commencement of the third end, Barrie Lester on screen, who once again has been superb in this finale, but Dandenong Club trailing by 5 points.
Yeah, end three, generally the moving end. It's generally the end when Dandenong skip away from sides as well, but at this stage, they're trailing by five. They don't want the point getting too far away from them. Axon, we saw with his third bowl on the previous end, Jack in the ditch. Very aggressive. That's the way him and Forsyth will play. If they see a shot, they'll go for it. Barrie Lester, he's setting a platform for Kelly. As always, Dandenong Club. Great front runners. Let's see what they got here. They've got a battle on their hands.
It's also the clash of nationalities this final too, isn't it, Chris? We've got the Australian on screen. He's paired with Northern Ireland's Gary Kelly. Obviously, Dave Axon is a Welsh international. Ali Forsyth from New Zealand. And it's all happening.
Just highlights the calibre of players we've got in the UBC. Four national stars. Massive on the world circuit. Stars of the UBC.
Now, Axon sends another down. The point in control at the moment. And this won't hurt either.
Yeah, just needed to hurry that line there. But good bowls in the head. Shot to Dandenong. Trailing 23-28. Barrie Lester would love to get a little touch on the jack here. Trail it behind his own. And of course, he'd get an extra 3 points for that.
So the left-hander sends another one down. He's out after it, which is generally a good sign. And both Kelly and Lester urging it on.
Very rare here. Five bowls have gone down and nothing past the jack. I reckon we're going to see a bit of weight here from Axon. Maybe a replay of last end where he got the jack in the ditch. Big weight here. Yes, big weight here from Axon. He's following it. Generally a good sign. We can hear Ali. Okay, he's removed two of the blue Dandenong bowls. Still, shot remains. So, score 26-28. Bowls gone everywhere there.
They certainly have. Everywhere but the restaurant. And there it is again. Great control. And scatters them.
Yeah, tad unfortunate though. Did remove two blue Dandenong bowls, but he removed two of his own as well. Just one bowl remains near the jack there. Plenty of room. Two world-class players, Kelly and Forsyth. Plenty of room for those two lads.
Gary Kelly in action again. Just a two-point margin. Lester animated as always. And just pulls up short of a toucher.
Well, the good news for the point here is they've got the back bowl. So if Ali selects to run, he has got the back bowl. I think he will. That's the way he's setting up. Weight here from Forsyth. Just swinging weight. Not big. Once again, just a touch high there. Mm. Not like Forsyth at all. Probably one of the world's best runners, if not the best. Kelly looking to add another shot here. It will be interesting to see if Forsyth elects to run again. Very rarely does he miss two in a row.
How good is the atmosphere in here? Crowd singing along, oh, having a ball.
It's pumping. I'm loving it.
There can be no argument about the impact this tournament has made on the world of bowls. The format, the colour, the excitement, the media coverage, unparalleled. Let's throw in the prize money too.
Well, if you want
the biggest in the world.
Yeah, prize money. If you want an endorsement too, you just have to have a look at the crowd. You've got the world's best players watching. Generally, they don't do a lot of watching. They love playing, but don't do a lot of watching. But they're all sitting there. They're all standing there. They're all watching this final. They don't want to miss a shot. Ali Forsyth, he won't be running again. He's had two runners, one missed, one removed, one bowl. Currently down first and second shot. Plenty of room here. We need to be down the ultimate end. Big bowl in the context of the match. Ali Forsyth, you're going to get down for the jack and the shot. Misses the jack. He grabs the shot. As you can see, he is very happy about that. Why wouldn't he be?
I wish he'd show some emotion and stop holding back. What about that?
Ali Forsyth, what a bowl. The point will continue to lead here, 38-34.
Indeed. The point doing at this second round what so many experts thought they would do in this championship, one of the glamour clubs. A break and then back with more.
Welcome back to Deer Park as our coverage of the Ultimate Bowls Championship continues. Let's hand it back to Greeny and get back to the game.
Thanks very much, Ebony. Ali Forsyth from the point. He delivered the goods last end, and that is why they're still leading 38-34. That score could have been completely different, Tappy. But the point, three ends in and still in the lead.
It's a very close finale. Script couldn't have been written any better. And they are slugging it out end for end. There's a bit of tit for tat about it. And Lester up on the mat. He was the man that got us underway in this final today. Great atmosphere at the Deer Park Club, and a huge rap to management and staff at this venue for the manner in which they've gone about their hosting responsibilities. Outstanding. And this looks to be not quite what Barry was looking for. Gary still provides acclamation, his teammate.
These four players, on paper, you'd expect a big game, but what they're delivering is just even better. The energy levels of all four players, very enthusiastic, but the bowls. And once again, David Axon delivers a toucher, a further 3 points. It's vital for the point they continue scoring, because we know the points that these boys have got.
And it's vital, conversely, that Dandenong Club stay with them. I know the format is conducive to anything being possible, but it possibly doesn't apply quite as much in the pressure cooker situation that we have here.
Currently 7 points the difference. Barrie Lester, he needs to hurry here for the jack. Gary Kelly did everything he could to get that towards.
Everything but kiss the bowl.
And a further 3 points there. The toucher coming up on screen, 37-41. Back-to-back touches. Barrie Lester, he loved it. He's just suited for this. He's suited for the format. He's suited for the TV, the lights.
41-37. Still anybody's. Axman and Forsyth. Brilliant.
It's just non-stop action. Bowl after bowl.
That's really the first time I've seen the point players relax and smile a bit in this game.
Well, they'd be happy right now. They know they're right in it. Halfway through N4, they lead by four. Currently holding the shot as well, courtesy of that fantastic last bowl of David Axon. Just splitting the two and running on. Almost ran on for the jack, which would have been a further 3 points. We'll get confirmation here of the shot. Samantha Nerona, our marker, just confirming there with David Axon. Barrie Lester, he'll come up. He'll give it the nod, whether it is orange or blue. Replay there. It just tit for tat.
It is indeed. A reminder also that as we watch this replay package, the management of the Ultimate Bowls Championship announcing in recent days that you can buy a share in a team participating in 2020 and beyond. So if you can't afford to field a team on your Pat Malone, you can buy into one, a bit like racehorse syndication, I guess. And you can just email mark@ultimatebowls.com.au for further information on that. Get involved, why not?
I love the syndication opportunity. Plenty of punters in bowls. I'll be all about that for next year. UBC continues to grow in such a short time frame as well.
Yeah, more Asian teams entering in 2020. Malaysia will have a presence in Hong Kong. There's John Green, left of screen, who's played a big role in the point landing in the final here tonight.
Landed themselves in quite a good spot as well, Tappy, as we see the scoreboard there, 44-37. Also just a touch short there. Sweet Caroline going on in the background. The crowd is loving it. But the focus on the four players just doesn't change.
Will there be a play in this end that's going to break the game apart? You've got to expect the unexpected because the unexpected so often happens.
Well, quite possibly. Interesting here, though. I'm always one for attacking, and that's where the scoring opportunities are for this match. But leading by seven and holding shot, Forsyth sees the benefit here in just covering around the left-hand side of the screen, potentially that last bowl of Kelly's. They don't mind. If they get first and third shot here, that's good hunting for the pointers. Kelly looking to turn this jack around the corner, and if he does, that crowd will get even louder.
As Alex Marshall, centre of screen, world number one. And, well, the pitches tell the story. Wonderful vibe in here. Penultimate end of this round of the championship. It's all up to Kelly and Lester to fire the next shot, if you like. They trail by seven. Kelly, freak of a player.
Oh, down on his forehand too, where he's produced the goods time and time again. Lester's willing it on. Will it get down?
Still going.
Not going to hurry far enough. Doesn't want to fall out, and it does. This could be first and third for the point.
Doesn't get any better than this. The Ultimate Bowls Championship at Deer Park. The business end of the event. You're watching the Ultimate Bowls Championship from Deer Park in Melbourne. Our coverage proudly supported by Ryman Healthcare, Aero Bowls, Sports Centre and the Deer Park Club. Well, wherever you might be watching, fasten your seatbelt. You're in for the ride of your life as we approach the fifth and final end here at Deer Park in round two of the Ultimate Bowls Championship. The point 57 lead Dandenong Club 42. David Axon on the mat. And this has been a thrilling final so far.
Yeah, the point have led all the way. But it's the fifth and final end that matters. They need to be leading. The last of these bowls go down from the skippers, Kelly and Forsyth. 15 points the difference. We know 10 points for first shot, 5 for second, 3 for third. So the ultimate end, that's worth 18 by itself. Going a couple of touches and the lead shot. Anything's possible here. Plenty of options still ahead for Dandenong.
No ultimate end has been scored thus far in this final. And we have Axon and Lester going head to head here.
Been a great battle between the leads. Say Axon, just a couple of conversion shots have made the difference. Look at that, leading.
Goodness.
It should be. He's leading like he's been doing it for years, but he plays skip. He's a back-end player, but he
It's been fantastic here. UBC event number two. Just drawing shots, setting it up for Forsyth, putting them in the position to lead 57-42 final end.
If you like what you're seeing, a reminder, Moama in Victoria hosting the third and final round for this year, December 12 and 13. It'll be televised right here. Once again, this event being televised into 23 countries around the world, which is phenomenal.
Axon down on his backhand, just looking to cover here. Already has lead shot. Tell you what, Barrie Lester, last bowl of the final, unless we have an extra end, of course, but he needs to make it a big one. He needs to at least get shot here. The lead shot to the point, that would move the margin along to 18, which would mean an ultimate end needed. Barrie Lester, he'll be looking just to land the jack here, squeezed out the side. Kelly likes it, Lester likes it. He can get down for the jack here. He does touch it, 3 points out to his own, a further 3 points just for that bowl, 6 points. You can look at the margin. Hey, so 3 points for the toucher, 3 points for lead shot. The margin back to nine.
Have a look at Barry and Gary. Absolutely loving this. Lead shot to Dandenong Club. No one can say that Barrie Lester is anything other than very good for this sport. A showman through and through.
They're a good dynamic duo. Barrie and Gary tag as well. Forsyth, he'll be looking to draw right on top here, especially with his first bowl. Take a little bit of pressure off. Well, Ali Forsyth, and
ridiculous.
He gets a toucher.
That is ridiculous. How good is the standard of bowls we are seeing?
How good's the footage of the players as well? Look at that energy, Ali Forsyth. Tell you what, if there's a big bowl, you needed a player to play it, that's the man I'd get, Ali Forsyth, New Zealand legend. Not far behind though, Gary Kelly, some of the shots he's delivered, not just in this event, but event one as well. Looking to get down for the jack. He gets down a touch too far, but finishes in a really good spot there. Gives himself an opportunity later on. Tappy, the way this is set up, the best shot here is Forsyth, just a foot past the jack. He wants to leave it because, as we know, Dandenong needs some touches. So you leave the jack where it is, the bowl where it is, sort of almost half covered. Doesn't want to open it up. If he can get just past, it's fantastic.
He's hearing you. A little smile on Axon's face.
Well, the boys, they don't want to rock this out. Well, unfortunately, just rocks it out. Yes, it is first and second shot. That's the good news. The bad news, the jack's out a little bit now. And Gary Kelly, he sees a full jack. His eyes light up. He'll be looking to trail this jack around the corner. That'll give him 3 points. Well, he trails the jack here, 3 points. If he's holding first and second shot, or even first, second, and third, it'll actually be a match line. They came into this end 15 points behind. Lester, he'll tell us the story. Well, look at him, down on all fours. He's got the jack. And Dandenong now hold a match lie, championship lie.
This is bordering on insane.
I can't believe what I'm seeing. 15 points behind. And look what they've done. Barrie Lester with his third bowl changed it all up. But Gary Kelly there, Forsyth needs to draw this. But then Kelly's still got a bowl to go. He can remove it. All the pressure now back on the point. Yes, they lead by nine on the scoreboard, but with first and second shots here going the way of Dandenong, potentially.
Wow, Gary Kelly, he is some player. Never say die. The point have one hand on the winner's check.
Needs to hurry here, Tappy, really needs to hurry. He's done enough for the shot, but Gary Kelly, he'll be playing backhand, he'll be playing weight. The potential here, he gets the jack, so he'll get 3 points and the shot, so that's 13. He'll also get the third shot, 16. I'm just going through these scores in my head, Tappy.
Yep.
5 points would go the way of the point. That'd be enough for Dandenong. So if Kelly is to get the jack and stays in bound with the shot, that's enough to win the match and the title. He can also get the bowl, remove the bowl, the first and second shot. Big bowl coming up here.
We still remember what he delivered in the quarterfinal of Event 1 at Warilla with his last bowl.
That shot. That's what they call it now.
Yeah, it's that shot that's been seen all around the world.
What does he have in store for us? It's been magic so far.
The boys are still watching it. Generally, that's a good sign. Is he going to hold up for the bowl? Through the gap, Barrie Lester. Oh, Kelly.
Look, well, that's
it. Boys are already partying.
That's it. John Green is already on the rink. Lester and Kelly gallant in defeat. Such an enjoyable finale. Hope you've liked what you've seen. Wherever you're watching, congratulations to the Point. Man beside me has a tear in his eye, a club that he is very closely affiliated with.
Tappy, I want another five ends. The viewers out there want another five ends. It went too quick. What brilliant bowls. Axon, he cannot believe it. There'll be family over in Wales watching, so proud of him.
Wayne Turley on screen, played his role. Barrie sees his wife, Miranda. We interviewed her a couple of episodes ago, you remember. She said, he stresses me out playing this game.
Replay here of Forsyth with his last bowl. He knew, down match, he's just waiting. First bowl here from Forsyth on the final end. He got down for the toucher, and that was a big bowl.
Some wonderful pitches, a great recap of a fine performance by the Point. Let's head downstairs.
Okay, just on behalf of the Point, I'd just like to say a massive thank you to the UBC and to the Deer Park Bowling Club for the last 2 days. Absolutely fantastic. To everyone that turned up to watch, it's been great to play in front of a big crowd, so well done and thank you very much. Just on behalf of the players, thanks to all the sponsors, especially our sponsor, Dan, and to our board at Tarrant Point have really put faith in us to be part in such a great concept. So just thank you very much. Thanks very much for a great final, guys. You played outstanding and had another great tournament. You guys are brilliant. Well done.
Very, very well said, Ali Forsyth. There it is for you on screen. Make sure you don't miss it. December 12 and 13, the Moama Bowling Club in Victoria to host the final round of this inaugural championship. What a season it has been in 2019. Great to work with you, Chris. A fabulous final.
Loving it, Tappy. The bowl's brilliant. Look, I can't wait for Moama. Warilla was fantastic. Deer Park, brilliant. But everybody, tune in for Moama, 12, 13 of December. We'll be right back.